And the Capitol's Visitor Center.
Thank you. We only ask two things of you. Is playing. Please, no eating or drinking.
Thank you. while I talk, I just ask that you stay put. And everybody that's on over here really needs to take a few steps this way because we're crowding my comments and we're shooting for the other girls who are in there. Alright guys, welcome to the rotunda. This is the room you guys came to see. I get it. It's pretty cool. This is actually the only room left in the entire United States Capitol that's still used for its original intended purpose. Were any of you impressed when you came in the room? Yeah? Mission accomplished! We did it! Yay! That's what it's here for, you guys. It's here to be impressive. Once the center section opens, and on this level it's about 1826, this doorway right here becomes the main entrance for visitors to the United States Capitol. The first thing anyone sees at the inside of the building is this room. Now this is also where we have our lying in state and lying in honor ceremonies. The most recent was a lying in honor ceremony for a man from Georgia named Colonel Ralph Puckett Jr. He was the last surviving Korean War recipient of the Congressional Medal of Honor. And I can tell you folks, as the very proud granddaughter of a World War II vet myself, it was an incredible experience to be able to pay my respects to Colonel Puckett. Now, you guys are more than welcome to take pictures while I talk. I just ask that we stay put, right? Can't remember if I said it. It's been that kind of day. But I was just gonna say before I jump into too many stories in here, because let's face it, I could talk the hind legs off a donkey. Is there anything specific you guys want to know about, or just a little bit of everything?
Do you have any questions?
Yeah? All right, let's do it too. If everybody looks straight up, this is the Apotheosis of Washington, painted by the Italian immigrant Constantino Bernini in 1865. It is in true fresco, took him 11 months. If you're having a hard time finding George Washington up there, just look for the guy in the blue jacket, pink blanket on his lap, sitting on top of the room. He's around 15 women. That's actually pretty cool symbolism, because we've got victory and liberty on either side. Any questions?
What's the significance of that centerpiece?
The significance of the centerpiece. So, on one hand, it doesn't have much significance in the sense that the practicality of it, it's roofed off because when there's a million billion people in here, members of Congress have a hard time getting through. So it acts as a hallway for them. Now, it is a place that I think needs to be treated with some respect, as that's where we put the table for, and then put the casket on top of that table for a laying in state or a laying in honor. So just out of respect for those that have laying in state or honor, kind of be like, it's, you know, be respectful. The reason for the fact that it's got that circle in the middle, kind of for a weird reason. Originally, they thought, okay, we can't bury Washington in the crypt,
right?
But what we can do is have a hole in the floor, and we'll put a statue of Washington down there, and that way people can look down, and the statue will be lit and be great and be wonderful. Any of you been to the American History Museum over part of the Smithsonian? Yeah? Any of you guys see Buff George? The giant statue of George Washington that like mimics Zeus, and he's standing there topless with a blanket over his left. Seriously, go to the Natural History Museum, it's there. That's what they were gonna put down there. They had commissioned the piece, and the artist delivers the piece, and they were like, guys, we can't. can't put that in. We can't put that in here. So it was out on the front lawn for a while, or rather East Plaza for a while, and went into the basement for a while, and eventually it ends up at the American History Museum down there on the National Mall. If you have a chance, I recommend checking it out because it is kind of funny, and you know, it's just, there's a lot of things. I mean, the apotheosis raising Washington to a godlike status, and you know, this one took it just a bit too far. No one wants to be that. We don't need to talk about Washington. Any other questions? All right, guys. I'm going to walk around the room so you can get pictures and then make like John Adams. It's like,
Parks, Dr. Bloom.
great. Miss Amelia Earhart over there. To give them the best future we can. So let's just make it a good one. Alright, any questions? Everybody that has a stake, get to see at least one stake. Speak now, forever hold your pieces, guys. You can go up and see what I mean when I say he's one of the most detailed. We're just going to let this group go.
Thank you.